What's going on, everybody? Welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm going to start a sorting tutorial series for every sorting algorithm in this tutorial series. And we are going to start with the simplest one, the bubble sort. And we are going to do every possible way to create the sorting algorithms. For example, you can create bubble sort in both iterative method with for loops and with recursion also. For every sorting algorithm, I will explain every detail, and we are going to take a look step by step and prefer which one to use. They are really similar and their complexities are both same. So let's start with bubble sort. I'm going to show you a little bit of simulation here to understand the algorithm. So let me annotate first. We assume that we have an array like this and we want to sort this array. So bubble sort will go like this. It will have two for loops, nested two for loops. And in each iteration, we are going to look for the maximum element and swap it with the other one, okay? So in here, we are going to iterate through n minus 1, because in each iteration, if the other one is greater than our current swap node, we are going to swap it with one next place. So for example, if our array has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 nodes, we are going to iterate through 6, because index starts from 0. So it will go like this. It will look here, so 29 here. It will look for the next element, so it's 10 now. And if it's greater than 10, these two will swap places. So 10 will be here, 29 will be here. And after this, since now 29 is here, it will compare it with the next element. And this is 14, so it will swap again. So here will be 14 and here will be 29. So it will look for it again, 29 and 37. Since 37 is greater, we are not going to do any operation. And now we are at 37, the same process. So 37 will come here, 14 will come here, and so on. And we are going to do this for 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 times. So n times, n minus 1 times. You can think of it like this. Alright, so now let's see the simulation first. So now I'm sorting our algorithm. 29 swap place with 10. Goes on, goes on, goes on. And after each for loop, we are going to decrement our index with 1. So first for loop will go through 6, 5, 4, and so on. Let's wait for it to finish, then let's start to write our code. Alright, so actually this is it, guys. So let's try to write our code now. Let's call this bubblesort.c++. I'm just including simple libraries here. And in our integer main, we are going to have an integer array, and for simplicity, let's take it the same as here. I'm sorry, one second, please. I'll just copy here. Alright, so this is our array now, and we need to sort it. First, let's find its size. Size of all array divided by the first element. And let's try to write our algorithm now. So our bubble sort algorithm will have two parameters, integer array and the size of it. As you know, in C++, arrays are pointers, so if we change any element in here, it will be changed in our main function. And let's print our array first, for simplicity and for us to see it nicely. I'll just put a simple return here. Alright, so this is our array, so let's start to write it now. Condition, change current element if it's greater than current plus 1. So, as we've talked about, so our I will start from 0. This is the tricky part. I will go through 1 to n minus 1, 0 to n minus 1. This is because we are going to swap the next element of it. So we need to decrement our for loop by 1. So our second for loop is a little bit different. It will go like this. I'll explain why it's like this now. N minus E minus I minus 1 and J plus plus. So if you're curious why is this N minus I minus 1, if you take a simple check here, when I is 0, so I is 0 and N is what size of this array, so this will go like a reverse loop. So like 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And we are going to do our swap operations in here. So as you remember from this graph, we need to sort our algorithm if the next element is smaller than our current element. So if our rj is bigger than rj plus 1, we are just going to swap rj and rj plus 1. Actually, this is it, guys. So let's try our code now. I'm calling a bubble sort algorithm, array and n, and I'm printing it again. As you can see, we've successfully sorted our array now. So as for time complexities, as you can see, there are two nested for loops here, and bubble sort takes an average of n squared time. So what does this n squared mean? This n squared means that it's not actually a perfect algorithm. Why it is not perfect? Because there are better algorithms than this, but bubble sort is the simplest one. That's why we started with it. And this is just it for bubble sort. It has an average time complexity of n squared. So in the next video, we are going to do bubble sort again, but now with recursive method. So see you in the next video, guys. Bye.